Conor was in the middle of saying something, so I was looking at him, and the chair went flying behind us. I thought that he threw the chair, that Eddie Alvarez did. But my guy has video footage. We looked at it. He was just fired up and just pushed the chair out of the way, and it just happened to slide across the floor. So Conor picks the chair up over his head like he's going to throw it at him. And I'm like, Conor, do not throw this chair. Do not. So I'm trying to stop it. I mean, you know, well, you got to realize these chairs are like 15 pounds. I mean, they're heavy metal chairs. He could have cut his finger. I mean, anything could have happened. It's just, I got to get some like plastic lawn furniture out at these press conferences now. These chairs are too nice. Freaking 20 minutes late again today at the press conference, you know what I mean? And he says crazy stuff. But much like anybody who has kids, you pick and choose your battles, you know what I mean? Like, him saying, I'm not coming to the press conference. Then guess what? You're not fighting on UFC 200.
Right.
You can't not show up to a press conference, you know? First of all, it's the most important day of the week other than the weigh-ins and the fight. You know what I mean? You can't miss it. So we pulled him out of 200. That fight was worth fighting for me, you know? But all this other stuff, like, you know, he's 20 minutes late and he's this and that. Believe me, I have guys up his ass wherever he's at, trying to rip him out of the room and get him to the press conference.
So
you know, the guys are all at the media all today. It's like, oh, he's 15 minutes late. What are you going to do? I'm going to sit here and wait for him like the rest of us. You know what I mean? What do you want me to do? What am I going to do?
Dude, my
There's
man.
Only so many battles you can fight. You know, I don't care what you have in life. The one thing that none of us have is time, you know? And it's just such a slap in the face. I get it. He's the king of mental warfare, and he wants to mess with his opponent. But these fans took time off work to come see this press conference. The media is there. The networks have a time that they go on. You have to respect other people's time. He knows. He knows. I don't even have to go there. He knows he's given up one of those belts. You
does
know?
He?
He does.
He does. You're sure?
I've said it at many press conferences while he was there. I've said it, and he knows.
What set off the late arrival, the chair grabbing, the whole deal from earlier today? I was in Gucci picking up this mink.
You look good in it. There's no doubt about it. Eddie, you said last
Thank
month.
Thank you. It's worth Eddie's show money.
Eddie, anything to say there?
Yeah, I actually, it's funny. I seen the tags hanging from it. I think he rented it. So you got found out, man. The tags were still hanging from your MIG. Yeah, either buy it or don't buy it, man. Come on.
Eddie, listen, you
that
said...
That cost more than your show course, Eddie.
Yeah, what? You didn't buy it, though.
Yeah, I bought it all cash.
You didn't buy
all
it.
All cash. Then take the tags off, Connor.
One of you guys will be
take
dressed for success.
Off,
one of you guys will be dressed for success on Saturday, either way. Listen, Eddie, I'm going to get back to you.
I think he stole it.
We'll wait to see if we can confirm that. Eddie, back to you. You've described yourself recently as a guy that's got the talent that Connor has, but you don't have the hype. Why do you say that's the case?
I was never concerned with being popular. Being in the sport, when I got into the sport, being popular wasn't a concern of mine. I've actually paid for it. I haven't got the paydays. I haven't got the things I should have. What I did do was I took the route of integrity. I took on the best guys in the world, one by one by one, and I've been top in the world for years. Years. This guy's just coming on the sport.
Come on, Eddie. You've been over in Japan or some shit. You've been fighting bums all your life. You've never been on this stage. You've never been against a guy like me. Yeah. You're an absolute bum. And you're trying to talk about a decorated career. You're an absolute bum. You get dropped every fight. Look at your face. You're the most beat up guy there is.
I look great in a suit. I look way better than you.
Cheap, the cheapest looking suit I've ever seen in my life. I swear to God, you're a bum, Eddie.
But I bought it. I didn't steal it. The tags aren't. I bought it. The tags ain't still hanging from it. So regardless of how much it costs, I bought it.